Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Pakistan has conveyed to the Afghan authorities its serious concern on the terrorist attack at Pannu cantonment on 15th of July and the continued use of Afghan territory by Hafiz Gul Bahadur Group and Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan to carry out deadly attacks in Pakistan with impunity. We strongly urge the interim Afghan government to take immediate, robust, and effective action against the perpetrators of the 15th of July attack and to prevent such attacks in the future. Such attacks undermine bilateral relations and regional stability. The Pannu cantonment attack underscores the urgent need for Afghanistan to take concrete and effective action against terrorist sanctuaries within its borders. Despite Pakistan's repeated calls for action, the presence of TTP and other terror groups in Afghanistan continues to pose a serious threat to regional peace and security. We urge Afghanistan to take effective action against these groups and to ensure that the Afghan territory is not used for terrorism against Pakistan. Pakistan remains committed to combating terrorism and ensuring the security of its people. Pakistan strongly condemns the dastardly terror attack of the 9th of Muharram on Imam Bargah Ali ibn Abu Talib in Muscat, Oman, that resulted in 6 deaths, including 4 Pakistani nationals. The attack on peaceful civilians in a mosque during the holy month of Muharram in the peaceful city of Muscat is reprehensible and inhumane. Such acts of terrorism and violence against peaceful civilians cannot be condoned on any grounds whatsoever. Pakistan condemns terrorism in all its forms and manifestations. This attack demonstrates the persistent threat of terrorism posed by terrorist organizations in the region. It is also a reminder that the importance to work together to fight these terrorist entities and to find common solutions to root out the menace from the region. We stand in solidarity with our brothers and sisters in Oman as they contend with this tragedy. Pakistan has offered all possible assistance to the Omani authorities in the investigation and in bringing to justice those responsible for this heinous crime in this holy month of Muharram. Pakistan also condemns in the strongest terms the continued genocidal barrage by Israeli occupation forces on the schools and shelters in Gaza. Over the last 10 days, they have attacked 8 schools in Gaza being used as sheltered by displaced civilians. The atrocious attack on the tents of displaced persons in Al-Mawasi area of Khan Yunus in southern Gaza resulted in the deaths of at least 90 Palestinians, including women and children, taking refuge in the camp. Targeting a camp that Israel itself designated as a safe zone is another violation of international humanitarian law. Pakistan also condemns measures being taken by Israel against the creation of a viable and independent Palestinian state. Israel has no locus standi to decide about the future of the lands belonging to the people of Palestine. Pakistan firmly believes that the only just solution to the Palestinian question is the creation of a viable, secure, contiguous, and sovereign state of Palestine on the basis of pre-1967 borders with Al-Quds al-Sharif as its capital. We are also concerned about the arrest of participants of a Muharram procession in Srinagar under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act for raising pro-Palestine slogans. The incident shows how easily and frequently counter-terrorism laws are being invoked by the Indian authorities to oppress and intimidate the Kashmiri people. We urge the occupation authorities to immediately drop the fabricated charges against the arrested mourners and release them immediately. Pakistan will continue to extend political, diplomatic, and moral support to our Kashmiri brothers and sisters for the just and peaceful settlement of the Jammu and Kashmir dispute in accordance with UN Security Council resolutions. Now an announcement. Foreign Minister of Turkmenistan, Rashid Meradov, will visit Pakistan from 22nd to 24th of July. He will hold extensive talks with Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister Muhammad Ishaq Dar and call on the Pakistani leadership. The talks between the two sides will cover all aspects of bilateral relations between Pakistan and Turkmenistan and exchange of views on regional and global developments. Thank you.